Welcome back to our channel Dentistry to the Point. If you are seeing this face for the very first time, hi, I'm dentist Saloni Jain and we make videos related to dentistry on our channel. In this video, we are going to start with a fresh new topic and a highly requested topic from all of you, that is candidiasis. Now, this is frankly speaking is a very important topic from the point of view, say, oral pathology as well as oral medicine, that is for third years and fourth years both. So be thorough with the topic and be with me throughout the video. And I've tried to cover all the aspects from the pathology as well as the medicine point of view. So let's get started. Now, candidiasis, as the name suggests, has got its other names, three other names, that are candidosis, moniliasis and thrush. Now, candidosis and moniliasis, because it is caused by an organism that is Candida albicans, also known as Monilia albicans. So that's why the two names are candidosis and moniliasis. And thrush, because there was a mycologist who studied candidiasis and the patches you see or the clinical features, the manifestations you see in candidiasis. So according to them, he named it as thrush. So the causative organism is Candida or Monilia albicans, which is a yeast-like fungus. Exists in three forms, that is your pseudo hyphae, yeast and chlamydophore. Grows rapidly at 27 to 35 degrees Celsius. Common inhabitant of the oral cavity, gastrointestinal tract and vagina, and when favorable conditions develop, transforms into its pathogenic form, that is from an inactive state of yeast to the hyphae, that is an active or pathogenic state, and it reproduces by asexual budding. So these are your rectification points or the points that increase the length of your long note question. Okay, so these are some basic intro points. Now moving on to the predisposing factors. Now as I've told you several times that predisposing factors are nothing but the underlying factors which aggravate the condition more. So there are around 8 factors and some rare factors also. Now a silly way to learn is for example, now it is very evident that in many diseases age plays a very important role, like the extreme ages, that is the young age, the old age and the pregnancy. Now these three ages are the prone ages which you're going to see common predisposing factors to many diseases. So we'll say infancy, pregnancy and old age. Then we'll start with mouth, as we are dealing with oral cavity all the time. So we'll start with mouth. So in mouth you have xerostomia, that is your dry mouth. Now don't worry, this is a separate topic to be dealt, a whole separate video is going to be made on this. Protective antifungal proteins, that is histamines and calproteins, are present in the saliva. Now since there is dryness of the mouth, so saliva is not going to be present in that amount, so these proteins are not present, hence it may predispose to candidiasis. Then from mouth you have xerostomia. Now you eat your medicines also through mouth, that is your prolonged use of antibiotics, corticosteroids, cytotoxic drugs. Also you take nutrition from your mouth. So nutritional deficiency like iron, vitamin A, vitamin B6, etc. Also poorly maintained dentures and heavy smoking. Okay, so these are all mouth related things. Now all these things are what? These are nothing but acute or chronic illnesses. Okay, so these are kind of like aap antibiotics le rahe hai, if you are taking medicines or if you have nutritional deficiencies. So what are all these? These are nothing but acute or chronic illnesses, that is your DM. These are nothing, we are relating it in a way, you can relate it anyway. You can also relate it as that firstly is ages, second is that any illness. Now how the illness develops, because of prolonged use of medicines or because of nutritional deficiencies. And to treat this, what you have to do is, that is hospitalization. So prolonged hospitalization for a chronic illness, or if radiation therapy or use of IV tubes, catheter, hat valves. Okay, so this is just a small way that firstly you consider the ages, then you talk about the oral cavity, then you talk about the corrections. So this way you can learn. Also some rare predisposing factors are immunodeficiencies diseases, that is AIDS, Addison's diseases, myxedema and hypoparathyroidism. Okay, so these are the predisposing factors, and this is whole about the intro of the candidiasis disease. Now we'll see the classification of candidiasis. Now moving on to the classification, so actually there are several classifications proposed, but the most accepted one is this, that is proposed by your Samaranike and modified by Axelettel. This was proposed in 1991 and it was modified in 1997. These are just the dates and the years which you don't have to remember, just for knowledge purpose. But yes, it was proposed and modified, and this is the most accepted classification for candidiasis. So it is divided into two types, namely primary oral candidiasis and secondary oral candidiasis. And these are the various manifestations, and we are going to discuss them each in detail one by one. So firstly, we'll see the classification, that is your primary oral candidiasis, which is divided again into four forms, namely your acute form, chronic form, candida associated lesions, and keratinized primary lesions super infected with candida. Now, a small trick that you can devise to remember the headings are, firstly is, yahan se you can remember acute, break it, acute, chronic, candida, super. So, as we are talking about candidiasis, so we are describing candida as a acute, chronic, candida, super. Okay, so you can remember acute, chronic, candida, and from here you can remember super infected ka super. So, aisa. So, acute, chronic, candida, super. Okay, so in acute form you have pseudomembranous and erythematous. In chronic form you have hyperplastic, nodular, and plaque-like. These three are new. Rest the two, that is your pseudomembranous and erythematous, are the repeated ones. Then in candida associated, now since the word associated had come, so now candida is an oral cavity form. Okay, now here we are talking about the oral cavity primarily. So associated, as it is going to also involve the surrounding structures or associated structures. So first is denture stomatitis. From there you can remember, okay, so associated is your palate, so denture. Then you have angular chelitis, that is involving the corners of the mouth, that is your lips. Chelitis is actually lips. So from there you can remember lips. And median rhombal glossitis, which we have already discussed in developmental anomalies of the tongue. So here it is involving the tongue. So if you haven't checked that, please do. I'll give the link in the description box and also pop an I button. So here this could be remembered as with your denture, lips, and tongue, because candida is in association with something. So these three. And then you have keratinized primary lesion, which is super infected with candida. That is, already a lesion is present which is infected with candida. So super is keratinized lesions, as in those are which white in appearance. So leucoplakia, lichen planus, and leucorhizomatosis, these are your keratinized lesions which are super infected with candida. In secondary oral candidiasis, you have oral manifestations of systemic mucus candidiasis as a result of diseases such as thymic aplasia and candidiasis endocrinopathy syndrome. Okay, so the various systemic mucocutaneous candidiasis are your chronic mucocutaneous candidiasis, chronic localized mucocutaneous candidiasis, chronic diffuse mucocutaneous candidiasis, and lastly that is the candidiasis endocrinopathy syndrome. So these will deal separately, these will deal separately. So everything is to be dealt separately. These are just the classification, a proposed classification for candidiasis. So this is all for today's video. In the upcoming videos, we'll be dealing with the important forms like the pseudomembranous, erythematous, hyperplastic, denture stomatitis, angular cheilitis, and the secondary forms. So stay tuned for it. And if you enjoyed and understood the basic concept of candidiasis, then please hit the like button, share, subscribe to our channel. Also comment down below if you have any kind of doubts. And hit the bell icon so that you're notified every time we upload a video. Stay tuned. Thank you so much.